Greetings for the day, my friends. Welcome to our channel, and we hope you're enjoying the day so far. First, we'll start with an update as SpaceX adds a fourth tower segment on Florida Starship launch pad, and then we'll move on to our second and final piece to provide an update on the SpaceX Falcon Heavy's planned launch of NASA's Roman Space Telescope. So let's start with Starship. After installing the first three segments of the tower's nine-part structure last month, SpaceX carried the fourth portion of the Starship launch pad gantry to launch Complex 39A on Wednesday night for stacking. Around dusk on Wednesday, the 7-mile or 11-kilometer long process of moving the five-story structure from the SpaceX construction site at the company's Roberts Road plant to Pad 39A was finished. The self-propelled transporter with 96 wheels that the gantry piece was riding on traveled to Pad 39A. On Thursday morning, a sizable crane went into position over the tower segment in preparation of lowering it into position on the tower. The Super Heavy booster and Starship rocket will be launched from the Florida launch pad, which is anticipated to mimic the tower SpaceX built at Boca Chica Beach in Texas last year, where the company expects to conduct its first orbital test flight. According to Elon Musk, the CEO of SpaceX, operational Super Heavy and Starship flights will probably be launched from Florida. About 1,000 feet or 300 meters east of the spot where SpaceX launches Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets, delivering satellites and people into orbit, the launch pad tower at Pad 39A is now under construction. SpaceX does not intend to excavate a flame trench for the Starbase pad at Kennedy, similar to the launch facility in Texas. The Super Heavy booster, with roughly 33 methane-fueled Raptor engines, will take off from its elevated launch mount with around 17 million pounds of thrust, nearly twice that of NASA's most powerful rocket, the Space Launch System, a fully expendable vehicle. The Super Heavy and Starship stack, comprising the rocket's first and second stages, will be fully reusable. The entire rocket stands nearly 400 feet or 120 meters tall and is made of stainless steel. SpaceX plans to move the remaining tower segments to Pad 39A in the coming weeks, aiming to finish the tower structure as soon as next month. The teams will move the Super Heavy launch pedestal and articulating chopstick arms for integration on the launch site at Pad 39A. To stack the Starship atop the Super Heavy rocket, the arms will be utilized. The 30-foot-wide or 9-meter Super Heavy booster, according to the business, will be caught by the arms when it returns to Earth for landing. Let's move to our second update now. NASA has selected SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket to launch its next significant space telescope, an observatory with a wide field of view that should work in harmony with the recently launched James Webb Space Telescope. NASA recently renamed the mission in honor of Nancy Grace Roman, a driving influence behind the Hubble Space Telescope and the Wide Field Infrared Survey Telescope, which was the program's previous designation. Given that the U.S. National Reconnaissance Office, NRO, chose to give an underused multi-billion dollar spy satellite, a satellite that was essentially a hidden Earth-facing counterpart of Hubble, the Roman Space Telescope's basic architecture is fittingly similar to Hubble in many ways. But due to decades of improvements in electronics, electromechanics, and the instrumentation side of spacecraft and space observatories, RST will be significantly more capable than the Hubble telescope it resembles. Falcon Heavy continues to show itself to be a bit of a contradiction, winning contract after contract for progressively more expensive flagship launches, despite the fact that it hasn't launched in well over 3 years. At this point, it's relatively predictable that there will be significant spacecraft side delays due to the fact that Falcon Heavy is being employed more frequently for critical missions. The likelihood is that Falcon Heavy won't even try to take off. For instance, SpaceX had 5 prospective Falcon Heavy launches, all but one of which had been delayed by several months to a year or more. Provisionally scheduled at one point in late 2021 for 2022, 7 months into 2022, none of these missions have yet been launched, and it's increasingly apparent that Falcon Heavy will be lucky to fly even once this year. An impressive manifest that includes the Roman Space Telescope, includes the multi-billion dollar GOES-U weather satellite, NASA's $5 billion Europa Clipper, two modules, HALO and PPE, of a moon-orbiting space station, the NASA Psyche Asteroid Explorer, a sizable astrobotic Griffin lander carrying the NASA Viper moon rover, two sizable geostationary communication satellites, and three U.S. military missions. RST is the 11th launch contract for the rocket between now and the middle of the 2020s. RST's primary wide-field instrument will have a field of view 100 times larger than Hubble's, despite having a similar resolving power. As a result, the new telescope will be able to gather magnitudes more data in the same amount of time. Its main objectives include measuring light from a billion galaxies over the course of the mission lifetime, and conducting a micro-lensing survey of the inner Milky Way to find about 2,600 exoplanets. A second coronagraph instrument will perform high-contrast imaging and spectroscopy of dozens of individual nearby exoplanets. As per NASA, the telescope's science program also includes dedicated investigations to tackle outstanding questions about the nature and effects of dark energy and dark matter, as well as a substantial general investigator program that enable further studies of astrophysical phenomena to advance other science goals. The James Webb Space Telescope may benefit greatly from having RST as a companion because it's also focused on infrared light wavelengths. RST is a wide-field survey observatory with the goal of observing and cataloging billions of galaxies, stars, and planets, whereas JWST's much larger mirror is suited for close inspection of specific targets or in-depth observations of minute regions of the sky. RST may ultimately function similarly to an MRI or CAT scan for JWST's biopsy, directing the surgeon where to look while merely speculating on what they may discover. In order to transport the spacecraft to the Sun-Earth L2 Lagrange point, which is around 800,000 kilometers or 500,000 miles away, NASA estimates that the Falcon Heavy launch contract for the $4.3 billion space telescope will cost an extraordinarily high $255 million. NASA will reportedly pay less than $180 million to launch the significantly more expensive Europa Clipper spacecraft all the way to Jupiter using a fully refuelable Falcon Heavy rocket. NASA has announced that RST will be ready for flight as early as October 2026. A previous news release from September 2021 just mentioned the launch date of May 2027 and omitted the 2026 goal. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.